Hi, in this video we are going to talk about how to deliver different files from an ACES project using DaVinci Resolve. First, we are going to explain how to export display referred deliverables, and at the end, we are going to explain how to export ACES 2065-1 deliverables, such as for VFX or archival, which will be the scene referred deliveries. If you want to learn the different options to export IMF packages from Resolve, you can click on the link, since there is a dedicated video for that. Let's start. What are the differences between these two categories? Scene referred and display referred? Display referred deliveries is the name we give to those deliverables whose color space and transfer function match those of a specific target display, such as REC709BD1886 or sRGB. Example of display referred images might be dailies files for editing, QuickTime movies reference for review, IMF for broadcasting, or Video Display Master (VDM). In all cases, they can be exported as HDR or SDR, depending on the mastering and target display. Scene referred deliveries is the name we give to those deliverables whose hold as much information as possible from the camera sensor and represent the colors of the scene. In an ACES project, for example, these deliveries will be exported as linear AP0 ACES 2065-1, and these images are not intended to be viewed directly on a display without a viewing or output transform. Before exporting any display referred file, we need to make sure we know the target display of the deliverable. Some examples: dailies during production and QuickTime reference even up to the final delivery are usually rendered out in SDR REC709, because production crews reviewing these files commonly have only SDR REC709 displays available. Oftentimes, for renders during color grading and depending on the device the creative is using to review, we may render QuickTime reference in HDR. This is one of the great advantages of working in a color-managed workflow like ACES. We can render deliverables to different display technologies just by selecting a different output transform while maintaining the creative intent of the grade. To check this setting, we are going to open the project setting, select the gear at the bottom right side of the interface, then go to the color management menu and check in the ACES setting that the ODT matches with the display of the deliverable. In this example, we are going to export a file for a HDR graded show, so our ODT must match the color space of our HDR mastering monitor. Here we did our grade for a Netflix show in HDR on a Sony BBM X300 monitor. This means that we will select P3D65 ST2084,000 nits as the ODT. Let's hit save and we are ready to go to the deliver page to export with this display color space. Let's learn how we can make a Video Display Master, or VDM. What is a VDM? A Video Display Master is a delivery that will contain the graded show with a display color space baked in. It will be a high quality image sequence and will serve as the source for the IMF or any other deliverable. This used to be a required delivery for Netflix, now it's no longer required. But some teams still use VDMs to use as a source master when generating an IMF. We can export these files as 16-bit TIFF or DPX for HDR or SDR, but following the Dolby specs, we will need to make a TIFF 16-bit image sequence for HDR. In the deliver page, we can start as custom. Then, we are going to select the single clip option, in format TIFF, and in the codec choice RGB 16-bit. Netflix recommends to render your VDM already in UHD to match to the current IMF delivery requirement, since right now all IMFs delivered to Netflix must be UHD. Since Netflix no longer requires a VDM, you can select the naming conventions or your facility, or you can follow Netflix guidelines. Next to location, click Browse, and we are going to select the training folder and paste our file name. It is recommendable to add the color space as part of the file naming, as you see in our case. Below, we are going to find some other options in the advanced settings. It is recommended to select force sizing to high quality, and if you select force debayer to high quality, Resolve will debayer each raw file with the highest quality according to Resolve. But this may differ from your preferred debayering method. Feel free to select your preferred debayering algorithm and leave this option unchecked. If we want to save this setting as a preset to use in the future, we can click on the option buttons and save as a new preset with the name of BDM. Before we submit the render, it is important that we check that the ODT on the project level matches that of our deliverable. Since we already configured our ODT as HDR, ST2084, P3D65000 nits at the project level, we can go ahead and hit add to render queue and start render. Now we are going to export an HDR QuickTime reference for review. One thing to note is that in the case of QuickTime, Resolve will embed the color space as a metadata tag inside the QuickTime file based on what you select as your output transform. Make sure your ODT in the color management menu is set up as P3D65 PQ1000 nits before exporting your HDR file. To render out a compressed video reference in HDR, the best way to do this currently is to use the H.265 codec wrapped in a QuickTime file. This type of render is often referred to as HDR10 with the static metadata. In the deliver page, we can start as H.265 master preset. Make sure that the frame rate and that the resolution matches with your project. Let's set as a file name training underscore HDR underscore reference QT. Then, in the video menu in the encoding profile, we will change the default option from main to the main 10 to ensure our encode is 4:2 10-bit. Also remember that you can customize the sizing and the debayer quality in the advanced settings as we learned before. We can go ahead and hit add to render queue and start render. To transfer material between different departments inside an ACES workflow, for example, to send files for VFX or to make archival master like a non-graded archival master NAM, we need to export files with all the information, and this means, as we know by now, ACES 2065-1. For more information about ACES color spaces, click this link. Because ACES images are encoded in scene linear, the standard container for ACES images is an OpenEXR 16-bit half-float file sequence. By writing ACES files in the OpenEXR format, we preserve all the original scene information using an ultra-wide gamut color space and all the dynamic range from the capture. Let's see how to configure the color management settings for rendering out scene-referred deliverables. First, we are going to bypass the ODT. So let's go to the project settings in the right bottom part of the interface. Then, open the color management menu, and in the ACES output device transform menu, we are going to select no output transform. This setting will reveal the ACES AP0 linear data or ACES 2065-1. Now we can render out deliverables for exchanging ACES data like VFX or NAMs. What is a NAM? If you want to review the specs, here is the link, but here is a summary. The NAM is a picture archival master for Netflix. It's an acronym that stands for non-graded archival master. It is a file sequence of the program that matches the IMF picture, conform, and duration, but all the color and effects applied in the online process shall be removed. We can say it's a master of the program without any grading applied. Since the NAM must match the image on the final IMF, then it must include all the resizes done either in editorial or during the color grading process. Depending on the color management framework, the format can be DPX or EXR. In the case of ACES, this should always be EXR. The resolution is unique to each production, since Netflix would like to collect as much information as possible on how the show was captured. Usually the NAM resolution ends up being the same as the finishing workflow resolution, that is often defined by the VFX resolution. If the project has an output blanking applied to the top of the captured image, then the masking or any crop will need to be disabled for this delivery. In case you are in the process of delivering a NAM and have questions, I highly encourage you to reach out your Netflix representative to agree on the delivery resolution. Now we are going to explore a non-graded archival master, NAM. For this example, our camera captured in a 69 aspect ratio. Our working resolution was UHD, but the final aspect ratio was 2:1. All I need to do then is to get rid of the blanking to display the full image that was captured. Let's have a look at the sizing palette in the color page. In the option menu, select output sizing and let's reset the output blanking to 0. And then our blanking will be gone in our timeline. In this case, our NAM resolution will be UHD. But as explained before, the resolution conversation depends on the imaging pipeline of the project and is a conversation to be had with your Netflix representative. In the Deliver page, we are going to start with the custom settings icon. Select as a format EXR. Netflix will allow NAMs render as lossy compressed EXR format, like PIS or ZIP. In order to send files to Netflix, it is really important to follow some naming conventions. For more information, click this link. Next to the location, click Browse, and we are going to find a folder already with the convention, and in the file name, we are going to press Paste, and we will see the already saved name. This information is unique to each show. Project title, season and episode, asset type, in this case NAM, bit depth, in this case 16B, ACES version, transfer function, in this case linear, then date, NAM aspect ratio, and NAM resolution. Now we could hit render. But if we export like this, the render is going to have the grade printed. To quickly and easily disable the grade, we are going to open the advanced options and we are going to have a look at the enable flat pass setting. Flat pass is going to flatten or disable all the grading nodes in every clip. In order to activate this option, we are going to open the drop down menu and select always on. We are also going to leave disable sizing and blanking output off, since we want to keep all of the resizes on the program. One more thing to consider is that when you selecting flat pass always on, we will get rid of any sizing you did on the node sizing page. This is why on a Netflix production, it is recommended to always do your resizes in online using either edit or input sizing and not at the node level. Finally, remember that you can customize the sizing and the debayer quality in the advanced settings as we learned before. Now let's hit add to render queue and render all. We are ready to render out a non-graded archival master, or as we call it, NAM. This method can be used to render NAMs, but also to render out 2065-1 VFX plates. When exporting VFX plates, the only difference could be the resolution and framing of the image, since it may differ from the NAM's framing and resolution. If you have any questions, we recommend you to refer the Netflix representative to solve any further questions regarding the image pipeline of your project. Hopefully this video has provided enough information on how to export VDM and ACES 2065-1 files. See you in the next videos.